The 24 most affected districts with foot and mouth disease are districts within transit routes stretching from Koboko, Isinjiro, Chiruhura, Kazo, Sembabule, Kalungu, Kampala, Chiboga, Lyantonde, Rakai, Kiryandongo, Rubirizi, Chankwanzi, Mukono, Masindi, Wakiso, among others. The domestic animals that are mostly affected by foot and mouth disease include cattle, sheep, goats, and pigs. In the wild, buffaloes, antelopes, and wild pigs are also some of the easy targets for the disease.
Majority of these districts are transit routes, and we are on high alert to make sure that they are covered. FMD control regulations. The district veterinary officer will collect the FMD vaccine from the ministry headquarters and transport to the districts to farms, ensuring that the cold chain is maintained. Vaccination shall be undertaken by only government personnel, and accountability will be provided to Ministry of Agriculture, including the telephone contacts of the farmers. A form to capture this data has already been circulated and provided to the district veterinary officer.
A strong caution has been sounded to the district veterinary officers to desist from selling the vaccines to the farmers because they are meant to be free of charge and compulsory.
It has been reported in the media that some vets are selling vaccine. Nobody imports vaccine, FMD vaccine, except the Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries. Anybody selling vaccine, therefore, is selling government vaccine and should be reported to the Commissioner of Animal Health or Director Animal Resources.
The affected districts have been urged to continue adhering to the quarantine restrictions as imposed by the Commissioner Animal Health Unit until the appropriate time when the restrictions will be lifted to allow safe trade.
We have witnessed people having serious weddings in these affected areas, and that is a source of spread of this disease, because the FMD in nature is viral, and you can step on fecal material or infected particles or articles, and you carry it home. So we should encourage the farmers and people to avoid attending weddings and parties in affected areas.
The minister contends that the economic consequences that come with the disease are very diverse.
Importantly, they also affect our export. Like the affected districts, we are not getting milk and beef for export. So the economic consequence is very diverse.
Livestock farmers in Uganda have suffered unending foot and mouth disease outbreaks since the first case was recorded in 1953. Since then, outbreaks occur annually. However, government attributes the challenge to the uncompliant farmers who often break the quarantine guidelines.